हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सुकित राज, डीलिंग विद सोशल साइंस, सेंट जोसेफ इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल, विजयपुर। डियर चिल्ड्रन, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। वी आर इन द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट प्रीएम्बल एंड सर्टेन फीचर्स ऑफ आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, फंडामेंटल राइट्स। वेल, लेट अस स्टार्ट द लेसन। What is fundamental rights? Important one more question. What is fundamental rights? The right that constitution has given to the people called fundamental right. I repeat, the right that constitution has given to the people called fundamental rights. What are the importance of fundamental rights? Let us study. Fundamental rights are necessary for the development of the personality of citizen. And they are required to lead a civilized life and also essential for the success of democracy. There were 7 fundamental rights in the constitution, but through 44th amendment done in 1976, right to property has been abolished. And right now there are 6 fundamental rights in our constitution, like right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational right, right to constitutional remedies. So all the 6 fundamental rights are listed in the third part of our constitution. Article number 12 to 35 deals with the fundamental rights of our constitution. Let us discuss about first fundamental right, right to equality. As you know that right to equality listed under article number 14 to 18 of our constitution. This right is very essential for the success of democracy. If there is no equality, fundamental rights will not reach to everyone. It will be part of any one group of people. Under this right, all are equal socially and economically before the law. No one is above the law, all should get equal protection of the law, and none should be discriminated against on the basis of their caste, religion, gender, or place of birth. According to right to equality, no citizen should be restricted to enter shop, public restaurant, hotels, place of entertainment like park, theater, and place of worshipping based on their caste, religion, or place of birth. Under this right, untouchability practice is an offense. Untouchability is an ancient practice in which lower class people should maintain distance from the higher class people. So it is prohibited because it encourages inequality in the society. This right has enabled every citizen to get equal opportunity to join government services. Second fundamental right is right to freedom. Right to freedom listed under article number 19 to 22 of our constitution. It is one of the important fundamental right like right to equality. Under this right, people can express their own opinion without any prejudice. But our criticization should not cross the limit. People can conduct meeting without arms. Means there is opportunity to conduct a peaceful meeting. According to this right, people can establish any kind of organizations like political parties, religious or caste related organizations, linguistic organization, etc. We have freedom to move anywhere and to live anywhere in India. Today we can follow any profession of our desire, unlike Varna system. In Varna system, restrictions were there regard selection of profession. But in today's society, there is no restriction to follow any profession like doctor, lawyer, teacher, etc. This right is also called protective right because it protects a person by illegal arrest. So, no law of state or central government can occupy the life and freedom of a citizen. So this is importance of right to freedom. Third right is right against exploitation. Main aim of this right is to prevent exploitation of women, children, poor and helpless people in the society. Here, exploitation means abusing of weaker. Under this right, begging, sati system, devadasi system, child labor, immoral activities have been prohibited. As you know that sati system is harassment of women, because after the death of her husband, she should jump into the same pyre of her husband and sacrifice her leaves. In Devadasi system also can be seen harassment of women. Here, parents who have no child will offer to the god. According to offer, parents should send their first girl child to the temple. So she should live in the temple without any protection. During festival of temple, she should entertain people. So when she grew up, slowly it became an immoral activity. So, Right Against Exploitation oppose these practices and tries to protect them. Fourth fundamental right is right to freedom of religion. As you know that India is a secular country, so no religion has been declared as national religion. So citizen can accept any religion that their conscience dictates, which means what our inner mind approaches can choose that religion, practice and propagate it. But there are two restrictions regard right to freedom of religion. First one is, no one can be forced to pay taxes for the maintenance of religious centers like temple, church, mosque or other any religious centers. By self-interest we can pay, but forcefully nobody can collect it. Second one is, use of religious centers for a political or other any non-worshipping purpose has been prohibited. This is right to freedom of religion. Fifth fundamental right is cultural and educational right. Main aim of this right is to protect minor religion and languages. Because minor religion, language, culture followed by few number of people, so government tries to protect their interest. Under this right, no one can be denied admission in government aided institution or institution run by any minorities. So providing education opportunity to all, main aim of this right. Let us go to last right, right to constitutional remedies. Constitution has not only given fundamental rights and also guaranteed them under article number 32. Whenever the rights are violated either by a person or state or central government, the citizen may appeal directly to the Supreme Court for their protection. So this right is also known as protector of fundamental rights. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar has called this right the heart and soul of the Constitution. Not only Supreme Court, even the High Court also have the power to pass the following writs under article number 226. Writs means written notice against who are violating the rights. There are 5 writs under right to constitutional remedies. Let us study one by one. First one is habeas corpus. So this right protects individual right of a person. Here, order passed by the Supreme Court or High Court to produce a person within a specified time is called habeas corpus. According to habeas corpus, after arrest, within a 24 hours or one day, accused person should be presented to the court. So, it protects them by illegal arrest and punishment. Second remedy is mandamus. According to mandamus, when organs of government like legislature, executive or other any lower institutions of government fail to perform their duties, Supreme Court or High Court passes order to perform their works called mandamus. But this writ is not passed against governor or president. When governor or president goes against constitution, they are removed by parliament members through special procedure called motion of impeachment. Third remedy is prohibition. Prohibition and certiorari both are similar with small difference. In prohibition, when a subordinate court passes judgment by crossing its limitation of power or against constitution, higher court passes order against lower court called prohibition. So here, order can pass against lower court by higher court. At that time, without any documents, orally they can answer to the higher court. So this is called prohibition. But in certiorari, In same situation, lower court should answer higher court with all the documents related to their judgment. So this is called certiorari. So one simple difference we can find out between prohibition and certiorari regarding answering. In prohibition, orally they can answer to the higher court, but in certiorari, with all the documents, they should answer to the higher court. Last remedy is co-warrant. Main aim of this remedy is right person to occupy right public office or government job. So public office means government services or government job. Here, High Court passes order against a person who hold public office illegally by giving bribery and all. So this is called co-warrant. Its main aim is right person to occupy right public office. Along with these five remedies, public interest litigation also protects fundamental rights. Public interest litigation will protect life, legal right and environment from being polluted. Litigation means filing case. Individually or in group, people can file case against who are violating our rights and polluting the environment. In recent year, courts by its self-interest filing case against who are violating our rights and polluting environment. So this is called public interest litigation. Children, in this video we learned about 6 fundamental rights. In next part, we will learn fundamental duties and directive principle of state policy. Thank you.